Hello friends, in this video we discuss about RTN 950. RTN 950 and RTN 950A, two different versions of RTN 900 series. It is a new generation integrated microwave transmission system developed by Huawei, which can be installed easily and configured flexibly. It supports the convergence of up to 10 radio links and supports multiple production schemes. Here we discuss about hardware, slot layout, list of IDU boards and board working. RTN 950 hardware look like this. Chassis high 2U high IDU and board are pluggable. Pluggable are supported in it. You can easily plug the cord and unplug. And 1+1 protection for system control, switching and timing board. As there are two CSHUF cards available, one is in active mode and other is in standby mode. When one faulty, then other take guard and take the control. Maximum 6 IF board available. You can install 6 IF board. In RF configuration mode, you can configure 1+0 non-protection configuration and less than 5+0 non-protection configuration. And also 1+1 protection configuration and less than 4+0 protection configuration, and also the XPIC configuration. Let's discuss RTN950A hardware. It is same 2U high IDU, boards are also pluggable. A slight different here, integrated service boards on system control, switching and timing board. Because there is only one CSHU card, PIU ports also available on it, power ports, and also the all other ports are integrated. A maximum of 6 IF board available. Here also maximum 6 IO board you can install. RTN950A supports integrated IP radio, high bandwidth and high transmission efficiency. Let's check RTN950 slot layout. Slot layout like this. Slot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8. Look like this. And also slot 9 PIU card and slot 10 PIU card. And slot 11 is fan unit card. Next, RTN950A slot layout. As we discussed previously, only one CSHU card, so slot 7 for CSHO card and all other are same. As slot 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here, you can install 6 IO ports. And slot 11 for fan unit. Let's discuss CSHUF card, the most powerful card in RTN950. CSHUF board function as next generation hybrid system control, switching and timing boards on optics RTN950NEs. They provide 110G service port to schedule and transmit various services. In addition, they can apply in the super dual solution, STB solutions. Here we discuss different ports on CSHUF card available. Here is a USB port. USB port is used to connect to a VLAN module to implement wireless NMS access, and also used to take backup from CSHUF card into a USB. And there is a 10G port used for fiber optical modules for fiber interface. And there is a NMS port used for logging. And there is a EXT port used for any cascading port. There is a clock port for external clock port, external time port. And these mount and TOD port, outdoor cabinet monitoring port and external time port. Let's discuss LED identification option here on CSHUF card. First start with state. When state green on, board working normally. When red on, board faulty. When off, board not created or power off. Next one is program. When green on, software running properly. When green blinking, software is loading and boot state. When red on, software is lost during board running process. Next is sync. Sync related to clock. When green on, clock is working normally. When red on, synchronization is lost. Next one is service. When green on, system working normally. When red on, critical or major alarm active. Critical or major alarm showed here. When yellow on, minor or remote alarm generated. Next one is active or standby. As we know, two CSHUF card in RTN 950, one is in active mode and other is in standby mode. When active, green on, board is active. When off, board is in standby mode, other board is active. Okay. Then USB port. When green on, USB flash drive online. When green off, USB flash drive offline or not connected. Next one is L/A, which is fiber port identification. When yellow blinking, data transmitted normally. When red on, optical power alarm reported. Other control card also available, which can be used on RTN 950 or RTN 950A. CSHO card used on RTN 950 as power ports available on it. Also CSHOF also used on RTN 950A. CSH board and CSHUA board also used in RTN 950. Other cards or boards are installed on RTN 950 are IF cards, on which IF installed, which connected to ODU. There are a lot of IF card, some are listed here, we can discuss here. The IFU2 card, this is only one IF installed on it and ODU power switch like this, you can turn off or turn on, and other states, servers, link, ODU and other identification LEDs available here. IF2 is a universal IF board that supports the integrated IV radio link. Other are ISU2 card, also one IF port available, same here like this. ISU2 is a universal IF board that supports the integrated IV radio mode and SDH radio mode at the same time. Next one is ISX2, also one IF port available, also XPIC cables port available. ISX2 is a universal XPIC IF board and provides the XPIC function for signal transmitted, received in integrated IP radio mode and STH radio mode. ISV3 board are multi-purpose IF board that support integrated IP microwave, STH radio and also XPIC links. Other are ISM6 and ISM8 are most advanced IF board. ISM6 boards are new generation dual channel IF boards. Each ISM6 board provides two IF ports. ISM8 is a dual channel, provides two IF ports and also one combo port for fiber. This card used in RTN 950 for Ethernet interface and optical interface for cascading and for NMS to another RTNs. For example, we have EFP8 card, have 8 Ethernet ports, no optical ports, and EG4 have 2 optical ports and 4 Ethernet ports. Same EG4P has 4 Ethernet ports and 2 optical ports. Next, EM6 card have 6 Ethernet ports and 4 optical ports. EM6D card mostly used nowadays have 4 optical ports and 2 Ethernet ports. And similarly, EMS6 card have 4 Ethernet ports and 2 optical ports. That's all for the video. For more detail, you can check description. Both RTN 950 and 950A hardware manual available in description. You can download and check thoroughly. Thanks for watching, like and subscribe for more videos. Thank you.